Welcome to a lesson on switching the order of integration for double integrals. In this video, we will redo the problem solved in the video entitled Double Integrals and Volume over a General Region, Part 1. So you may also want to watch that video to compare the two different methods. So for this first example, our function is z equals x plus y, and the region is defined on the closed interval for x from 0 to y over 2, and from y on the closed interval from 0 to 6. If we go back to the previous presentation, here's the same problem where we solved it integrating with respect to x first and then y, and the answer was 45 cubic units. So we already know the answer should be 45, but now I want to integrate this function with respect to y first and then x. Let's start by taking a close look at this interval here. This compound inequality can be written so that x is greater than or equal to 0 and x is less than or equal to y over 2. So we know if x is positive, we're going to be in the first quadrant. Let's go ahead and solve this inequality for y. If we multiply both sides by 2, we'd have 2x is less than or equal to y. Or if we wanted to, we could write this as y is greater than or equal to 2x. So y greater than or equal to 2x would be this blue line here. And we would shade above the line because y is greater than or equal to 2x. And since y is on the interval from 0 to 6, this is our region of integration as we saw before. This line here is key to setting up this double integral correctly. This line could be expressed as y equals 2x or x equals y over 2. This would be x equals 0 along here. This point here would be 3, 6. And this segment here would be y equals 6. So let's see if we can set this up. Integrate with respect to y first and then x. Function is x plus y. If we would like to integrate with respect to y first, we must write the limits of integration in terms of x. So looking at how this region is bounded vertically, it's bounded below by either y equals 2x or x equals y over 2. But since it has to be expressed in terms of x, we're going to use 2x here. And then above, it's bounded by y equals 6. And then for x, the interval is from 0 to 3. And now we know this should equal 45, but let's go ahead and check it. Treating x as a constant, we'll have xy plus y squared over 2. Now we're going to replace y with 6 and 2x. So we're going to have 6x plus 6 squared over 2, that's going to be 18, minus, now we'll replace y with 2x, we'll have 2x squared, and here we're going to have 4x squared divided by 2, or 2x squared. Let's go ahead and combine our like terms, and then we'll integrate with respect to x. Looks like we'll have negative 4x squared plus 6x plus 18. Let's go ahead and complete this on the next slide. So we'll have negative 4 times x cubed over 3 plus 6 times x squared over 2 plus 18x. We'll evaluate this at 3 and 0. Let's go ahead and rewrite this. We'll have negative 4 thirds x cubed plus 3x squared plus 18x. Replacing x with 3, we'll have negative 4 thirds times 3 to the third plus 3 times 3 squared plus 18 times 3 minus, and then when x is 0, all these terms will be 0. This is going to be negative 36 plus 27 plus 54, and this does equal 45. By switching the order of integration, we did get the same answer, but what we had to do is make sure that we expressed the limits of integration for y in terms of x. So we did have to manipulate the equation x equals y over 2. Let's go ahead and try another one. Here we want to determine the volume under the surface defined by this region here, and we want to integrate with respect to x first and then y. Let's go back to our previous presentation to see what the answer is when we integrate with respect to y and then x. Again, here's the same problem where we had dy dx, and the answer came out to 1/24 cubic unit. Again, we used dy dx, And now I want the order to be dx dy. Our region of integration is bounded by the functions y equals x squared and y equals x. So here's y equals x, and here's y equals x squared. And the point of intersection here was the point 1, 1. So here's our region of integration. Let's see if we can set this up using the given order of integration. Our function is xy, and then we're going to use dx dy. So limits of integration for x need to be written in terms of y, which means we have to solve these equations for x. Well, this equation is already solved for x. We have x equals y. And then here to solve for x, we'd have to square root both sides of the equation. We would have x equals the square root of y. So the lower limit of integration for x is going to be y. And the upper limit of integration from this curve here is going to be the square root of y. Remember, if we have dx here, we have to have these written in terms of y. And then for the limits of integration for y, we just have from 0 up to 1. And again, we know from the previous presentation, this is going to be equal to 1/24 if we do it correctly. Let's go ahead and give it a try. So treating y as a constant, we're going to have x squared y over 2. And since we integrate with respect to x, we're going to replace x with the square root of y and y. So replacing x with the square root of y, we're going to have y squared over 2 minus, here we'd have y to the third over 2. So we're going to have 1/2 times y to the third over 3 minus 1/2 times y to the fourth over 4. Evaluated at 1 and 0. Let's finish this on the next slide. So here we have 1/6 y to the third minus 1/8 y to the fourth. So when y is 1, we'll have 1/6 minus 1/8 minus, and then when y is 0, these will both be 0. So we have 1/6 minus 1/8 common denominator of 24. So we have 4/24 minus 3/24. So it looks good. We have 1/24 just as before. If we take a look at the initial problem again, since y was already expressed in terms of x, as we saw in the previous video, the order of dy dx would have been a little bit less work. But if we're forced to integrate it in this order, we have to make sure that we express x in terms of y, because if we have dx here, the limits of integration must be expressed in terms of y. And we saw this in the previous example as well. I hope you found these examples helpful.